You know the childhood saying stick a needle in my eye? Well, it's supposed to show how serious you're about something and not actually mean you should stick a needle in your eye. But that's essentially what sclerotattooing is, using a needle to inject ink into the whites of your eyes, otherwise known as the sclera, to change their color. Kat Gallinger, a 24-year-old model from Ottawa, Canada, tried this form of eyeball tattooing with bad consequences and is now warning everyone about the dangers via social media. As you can see, pain, oozing purple tears, bad eye swelling and loss of vision resulted. She tried antibiotic eye drops but ended up having to go to a hospital. Time will tell how much of her vision she will end up regaining and whether more complications will occur. The eye is a complex structure and machine serving many purposes. Interfering with its structure in any way can be like randomly poking holes and injecting things into your car. Even if the needle doesn't go too deep, it still enters the cornea, the outermost layer of the eye, which, as the National Eye Institute, NEI, website describes, itself consists of several layers, with each playing an important function. The surface of the cornea is the epithelium, a lining of cells that helps your eye absorb oxygen and nutrients from tears and the outside world and protect your eye from foreign objects such as water, dust, dirt and microorganisms. Damaging your corneal epithelium in any way, including pushing a needle through it, can impair its ability to protect and feed your eye. Think of pushing a needle through the epithelium as poking some big holes through the outside doors and walls of your car. Even if you patch up the damage, your car may not ever be protected as well again. Your corneal epithelium also has thousands of nerve endings, which is why getting even a speck of dust in your eye can hurt so much. Pain is your body's way of saying, no, don't do this. Therefore, your body tends to have more nerve endings in areas that it wants to protect, like your groin and your eye. The next, deeper layer of the eye is Bowman's membrane, which provides further protection for the eye and consists of collagen. Messing around with a collagen layer can be like going to a well-manicured garden with a scimitar and randomly hacking away. Plants may grow back, but they often do so in a disorganized manner. Similarly, damaging the collagen layer with a needle and ink can lead to collagen regrowing to form a scar. Scars can then impair the ability to see. There's more collagen along with water in the next layer, the stroma, the thickest layer of the cornea. The combination of water and protein keeps the cornea rather elastic and transparent. Typically, there's fluid circulating that flows from inside the eye into the stroma and back out again with help from the endothelium, as described shortly. Below the stroma is Descemet's membrane, another protective layer. Having several protective layers is like wearing pants, pads, underwear and a cup while playing football. Sure, you can wear only a pair of underwear on the football field, but are you really ready to get tackled? And right under this membrane is the endothelium. Think of the endothelium as the sump pump for the stroma layer of the cornea, helping pump out fluid so that the stroma doesn't swell and become thick and opaque. Collectively, in addition to protecting the rest of your eye, the corneal layers handle a majority, 65% to 75%, of your eye's ability to focus light and images onto your retina, the structure responsible for transmitting images to your brain. Your cornea and your underlying lens bend the light in such a way that it hits the retina, which is in the back of your eyeball, appropriately. So damaging your cornea in any way can make images fuzzy, unfocused or even impossible to see. The other key role that the cornea plays is filtering out and protecting your lens and retina from the sun's damaging ultraviolet, UV, light. In other words, the cornea serves as sunscreen for the eye. Poking the cornea with holes and injecting ink in there can be like replacing sunscreen with salad dressing. All of this assumes that the needle and the ink don't go deeper than the cornea, which could very well happen since the cornea is connected to underlying structures such as the iris, lens, pupil, muscles, vitreous body, retina, nerves, etc. If any of these structures are damaged, further and even more serious injury could occur. Thus, eye tattooing is very dangerous. It is also very unregulated. There are no guarantees that the equipment being used is clean, that the tattoo artists have any knowledge or understanding of the eye, or that the materials being injected into your eye won't harm you. Beware of any claims made about the safety of eye tattooing. It could result in a bad infection and impairment or loss of vision. Even scarier is the fact that complications could be unseen or occur.